How's it going, everyone? This is Nintenjoe, and this is the fifth episode of Swag Snag. If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button and hit that little bell notification so you get notified every time I put a video, whenever that happens to be. So yeah, let's check it out. So, the first item I want to show you guys is a console, actually. My cousin Boss Rush Mode contacted me and asked me if I wanted this product, and so I was like, well, name your price, and he's like, oh, how about $200 for the system, a controller, everything that comes with it, and like a bunch of games. And he told me what games they were, and I'll show you the games in a moment, but the first thing I wanted to show you, TurboGrafx. I've never actually owned one as a kid. I would always play the TurboGrafx at Parasite Steve's house way back in the day, and I loved it. My favorite game is definitely Devil's Crush and Air Zonk. Those are my go-to, and those games were a lot of fun. This is an underrated system, to be honest with you. I hope, you know, at some point they'll do like a HD remake, or like do some kind of modding for this, so that I think that'd be really cool. So I'll show you the games now. These games are loose, but they're in little plastic cases, so it's not too bad. The first one I want to show you is Victory Run, a game I've never actually played before. I never really heard of it, but I'd like to check it out. Ninja Spirit, again, another game I'm not too familiar with, and I'm hoping to remedy that. Legendary Axe. Now, I believe I played this one. I'll have to, like, go back and play and see if I have played it or not. I kind of feel like I have. But, yeah, so that's cool. And, as I mentioned before, Devil's Crush. Amazing pinball game with the absolute best soundtrack ever for a pinball game. And it's just crazy how amazing the music is, and it's just a freaking pinball game. Like, why is the music so freaking good? Now on to the CIB complete in box. Didn't know what CIB was. Bloody Wolf, a game I've never played, but I know what it is. I've seen gameplay footage of it, and it looks really, really cool. Keith Courage, a game I've never played, but I know it was one of the very first games to come out for the system. Alien Crush. You can't have Devil's Crush without Alien Crush. I mean, come on. This is another awesome pinball game. I played this one to death as well. It's definitely one of my favorites. And yeah, I mean, they have the... I swear, like, TurboGrafx have like the best pinball games ever. They're so good. And Newtopia. I've never played this one, so I have no idea what this one's all about. And again, hopefully I'll get to remedy that. And of course, the controller. Gotta have at least one controller. At some point I'll like to buy the adapter for the 4-player and buy extra controllers. But I'll do that another time. Now, this is another game that I've never owned as a kid. And of course it's from Konami, it's for the Super Nintendo. And I'm pretty happy that Boss Rush was willing to sell this to me. And that's Turtles in Time. Arguably one of the best beat-em-ups of all time. I mean, I prefer the Manhattan Project myself, but this is a pretty dang cool game. I played this game to death. And yeah, it's wicked good. I love it. Complete in box. I mean, it's a little damaged, but you know, whatever. I don't really care. I don't plan on selling it or anything. I mean, I've waited all this time to finally own this, so this is not leaving my sight. Well, my possession, anyways. And also, I want to show you guys this little carrying case for like the loose carts. This is where the loose games were in previously, but I wanted to take them out and show you guys individually. So I thought that was really cool. So I gave Blast Rush Mode about $250 for everything, for all the stuff, the games, the Turtles in Time game. I mean, he could have gotten way more money if he sold it on eBay or Craigslist or something, but he figured, you know, keep it in the family, and, you know, he knows that I'll play these games and actually enjoy them, so I'm happy with that. That's really cool. And another thing that I forgot to show you guys on my a couple episodes ago, I was on Miketendo's Catslvania stream back in November, December? I think it was November, and whoever donated like $30 or more would be entered to win this particular prize. And of course, you know, I donated more than $30, and I love animals, so anything to help the fur babies out. So I just happened to be the winner of this little Dream Vision. I think that's what it's called. Yeah, Dream Vision virtual reality smartphone headset. So yeah, really cool. I haven't tried it yet, but I tried out someone else's and I thought it was pretty wild, so yeah. Seems pretty cool, so I'm sure I'll be enjoying this too. So if you like what you saw, please hit that subscribe button and also hit that little notification bell, so every time I post up a video you'll get notified, hopefully. And also, I'm in a podcast called Retro Ridoctopus, and you can find us at ridoctopus.buzzsprout.com. And so far we have 4 episodes up, so go ahead and check us out. Subscribe there, and yeah, I hope you guys enjoy. So, I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.